OnePlus, a rookie company that won the hearts of enthusiasts just shy of 7 years ago, is now in a confusing position. With its latest devices trying to hit too many targets at once, OnePlus has lost a bit of its brand identity as well as credibility as a top contender in the smartphone market. As such, OnePlus needs to remind consumers why it was so beloved in the first place. I'm Luke Pollack with Android Authority, and on the eve of the OnePlus 9 and 9 Pro launch, we're going to take a look at why it's high time for the brand that never settles to fish or cut bait. Back in 2014, OnePlus managed to pull off a big win with its first phone, the OnePlus One. Priced at just $299, the original flagship killer featured 3 GB of RAM, a stunning 5.5-inch 1080p display, the latest Snapdragon 801 processor, and support for modding. It was an instant hit among enthusiasts. In fact, the OnePlus One was so popular that by the end of 2014, OnePlus had sold over 1 million units, crushing its initial 50,000 unit sale goal. Now, right out of the gate, OnePlus had secured a place in the minds of geeks and techies alike, and it continued this momentum for years with a laser focus on a couple of key areas, the main of which was software. The OnePlus One launched running CyanogenOS, a fork of the vastly popular CyanogenMod mod. But due to some relationship issues with CyanogenMod, OnePlus very quickly adapted and released its own version of Android, OxygenOS. Now, OxygenOS, apart from some initial bugs, was a well-optimized, smooth, and overall great version of Android. It brought over many features such as theming and a screen recorder far before even stock Android released it. And for its users, this was a great step in the right direction. Not only was the hardware impressive for the price, but now the software was too. OnePlus had built a community of modders and enthusiasts alike and was actively listening to them. And for the most part, this carried all the way through to the OnePlus 7 series, with the company always offering a great price to performance ratio. However, if we fast forward to today, OnePlus isn't that same scrappy company it was years before. Albeit the brand did shift its focus to flagships in 2019 with the release of the OnePlus 7 Pro and then the later OnePlus 8 Pro, now its lineup is riddled with issues that have tempered expectations for new device launches. Don't get me wrong, OnePlus has and probably will continue to produce some great handsets, but now more than ever it needs to come up with something extra special or risk just becoming another Android brand. Let me explain. You might remember a video we produced earlier this year where we talked about the slow devolution of OnePlus's identity. The brand was becoming more and more like its budget-focused sister brand, Oppo. The most obvious example being OnePlus's latest budget introductions to the US market, the N10 and the M100. Both those phones target a budget audience, but struggle to compete with the likes of the Pixel 4a and the iPhone SE on anything but price. Typically, this wouldn't be a problem, but OnePlus is dangerously close to letting budget-focused devices seep into its flagship ones. Both the N10 and the M100 were less than ideal performers in their price range, and so was OnePlus's most recent stab at an affordable flagship, the OnePlus 8T, with it only barely hanging with the other competitors in the market, such as the Samsung Galaxy S20 FE. As a result, the company's image has become diluted. If OnePlus wants to remain a respected player in the game, then it needs to remind people that it can produce amazing products when it wants to. But as of right now, the line between its flagship devices and budget devices is a bit muddy. However, it's not just this recent track record of inconsistency that's the problem here. There are other issues that OnePlus needs to address if it wants to hang with the best in 2021. Historically, OnePlus devices have struggled their camera performance, leaving many enthusiasts with just an okay camera experience. But at this point, that's not enough. Even the very recent ROG Phone 5, a gaming-focused device, has a good camera. OnePlus's long-standing issue of providing mediocre cameras on flagship devices is non-excusable. This is also coupled with the rollout of OxygenOS 11, an update that made OnePlus's software experience look and feel more like Samsung's One UI, and that left a bad taste in the mouth of its die-hard fanbase. It feels like OnePlus is playing the numbers game with no clear strategy. It's appealing to the budget market, the flagship market, the mainstream market, but none of them are really hitting hard in any particular direction. So, with all of this in mind, we have to take a step back and look at how OnePlus 9 series plans on establishing its seat at the flagship table. While the 7 Pro and the 8 Pro were solid first entries into the premium flagship market, it's high time for OnePlus to stop trying to be the enthusiast-driven flagship killer. Instead, it must now become the flagship. First and foremost, we know that OnePlus is partnering with Hasselblad for the cameras in the 9 series. However, we've seen other smartphone manufacturers partner with camera companies and still produce some less than ideal results. Still, OnePlus needs to improve its camera performance for the company to be taken seriously with other flagships, and at the very least, the partnership with an established camera brand is a strong statement of intent. The company announced that the OnePlus 9 series will ship with a custom Sony IMX789 sensor. This will enable 12-bit RAW capture at 4K at 120fps or 8K in 30fps. In theory, this should improve performance in HDR and low light, as well as overall video quality. OnePlus also stated there will be another 50-megapixel Sony IMX786 sensor, although it's unclear as to whether or not this will be on just the Pro or both phones. Now, for the most part, I'm pretty excited about these changes, but if time has taught me anything, I know that real-life performance is what changes the game. Take, for instance, the Pixel series. Those devices have been using the same outdated 12-megapixel sensor for years, and yet they produce some of the best photos on the market due to Google Software Smarts. Still, on paper, the OnePlus 9 series looks like it will compete with 2021's photography powerhouses like the Galaxy S21 Ultra. Second, very recently, OnePlus revealed that the OnePlus 9 Pro will have a 120Hz LPTO display. Now, if you don't know what that means, without getting into too much detail, the 9 Pro will have a low-temperature polycrystalline oxide backplate underneath the OLED panel that should enable the phone to use less power when driving a high refresh rate. Whether or not this will be true remains to be seen. OnePlus is also calling this new display Fluid Display 2.0, with the main selling point being its adaptive refresh rate. The company is also claiming that the OnePlus 9 Pro can adjust its refresh rate down to as low as 1Hz, which means if you're looking at static content, the display will only refresh once per second. If this is legitimate, then these two technologies combined could make for a breakthrough in battery performance. OnePlus is also touting a new feature called HyperTouch, claiming a 25 to 30 millisecond reduction in latency, which should result in an overall improved gaming experience. Lastly, let's talk design. Recently, OnePlus devices all follow the same design trend, a trend primarily dominated by glass backs, curved displays, and large camera bumps. It's no different with the OnePlus 9 series. Taking some notes from the OnePlus Nord and the 8T, the OnePlus 9 and 9 Pro will feature larger, squared-off camera bumps in the top left corner. Due to its partnership with Hasselblad, the new devices will have the Hasselblad name etched into the camera modules. The Pro will feature 4 cameras, whereas the regular 9 will have 3. Overall, I think the design looks a bit more premium and interesting than the 8T. However, on a more sour note, it seems again that OnePlus is going with a curved edges on the screen, a trend that I personally would just like to see die. It was another gripe I had with the OnePlus 7 Pro, a phone that had a lot of issues with phantom touches. So I hope it's not too curved this time around. All in all, this design so far looks very similar to the previous iterations, but with a few tweaks here and there. So the 9 series is shaping up to be a solid contender in the premium flagship market. The new camera changes should hopefully be a big step in the right direction, the display technology could give OnePlus a leg up on the competition, and the design, while not revolutionary, still falls in line with OnePlus's better designed phones such as the 7 Pro and 8 Pro. Whether or not all of these features land to produce a complete package still remains to be seen. But if OnePlus can deliver on all of its promises, then the OnePlus 9 series might just be the final push it needs to crack the premium smartphone market. Alright, so that's going to wrap it up for this video. The OnePlus 9 series releases on March 23rd, so just make sure to keep an eye out for more content here on Android Authority. Lastly, comment down below what your thoughts are on how the 9 series is shaping up so far. I'm Luke Pollack with Android Authority, and I'll catch you in the next video.